Everyone, sorry, I am so late tonight. Absolute nightmare with my internet today and computers. It's because I've been doing a bit of decorating and I think I've disconnected a couple of wires. But it's all up and running now, so sorry, look, 5 minutes late. Sue me. Yeah, what can I do? Right, look, I didn't get a chance to put it on Facebook earlier either because I couldn't get on my internet. Look, right, this is the code, guys. Y41063, okay? That's all you got to do. So enter that code on quizbit.com and then enter your team name and then obviously enter that code and then we'll crack on. We've got like six really good rounds. We've got a little bit of potluck in there tonight, a little bit of TV, all sorts of things. But yeah, now join in the game. It's a bit of fun. Hopefully you'll enjoy the quiz tonight. Sorry, I'm decorating at the minute, so I've got everything everywhere. I'm trying to find somewhere I don't stand in paint. But hey ho. So, right, so just going to get you all up and running when it works. Right, hopefully. Well, the first round's a mystery round anyway, so we know that one, so there's a mystery about that one. The mystery is I can't seem to get any of you guys joining in. I don't know why. Tell you what, I'm going to start it again, all right? So let's just get this out of the way. Right, anyway, I think what you're going to have to do is just wait for this to count down and then we'll try and do a little bit of a refresh. Paige Brindley, hello. Hello, Paige Brindley. Let's have a look. Right, it's not going to work tonight on this one, ladies and gents. Let me go back out and we shall get you a new code, okay? We'll get you all the new codes. So stay with me here. I'm going to log back in and we'll get you a brand new spanking code when I find my pen. Here it is. Right. Okay. So we'll do same quiz. We'll do the same quiz. But not to worry about that one. There we are. Mighty quiz. Let's do that one. So I'll start the quiz. Right. The code tonight you're going to need. I'm going to type it on here as well. Okay. So you've all got it. Just connecting. Right. D82821. So that is. Sorry, I'm usually a lot more organised than this, ladies and gents. You know that. Okay, so but this is the code. I'm going to write it down. A little bit of Tony Art going on here. 8, 2, 1. Right, okay, this is the code. D82821. D82821. That's all you need to do. Louise Myers, we had a blooming search party sale for you. Yeah, I've had a bit of a nightmare today. I'm not going to lie to you. Yeah, we're up and running now. Okay, so I just need you all to obviously go in there and enter that code. So D82821. That's all you need to do, and then you can join in that way. Okay, so don't forget Quizbit and then D82821. That's all you got to do. So if you haven't played before, there's six rounds, 12 rounds, 12 questions every round. They're all different. Little bit of time delay. So obviously I'll speak it. You'll get it on your device, whether you're using a phone or a tablet or a laptop, whatever it might be, and get a little bit quicker. The quicker you answer the questions, though, ladies and gents, you're going to get a little bit more points. Yeah, the faster you answer it, it'll be great. If you don't answer this the last question, you're losing some points. Yeah, you're going to lose some points. That's why it's called the evil question. So you've got to get it right. So have a guess anyway, but get it right because you want them extra points. You don't lose 100 points. That'll just be rubbish, won't it? Yeah. Right, okay. So you should all be on there now. First round. Right, so again, a couple more minutes, just let the people catch up. So D82821. Louis says, just relieved you're okay. Yeah, I'm okay. Yeah, just manic. Obviously, the flat's looking good, though. I'm doing a lot of decorating upstairs, and it's... code again, please. Steve, yeah, no problem. D82821. That's the code. So I'll type it on here as well. So D82821. Yeah, there we are. So I'll send that across. There's the code. Well, hopefully we'll have our winners from last week, little old wine drinker me. She won it last week, first time. So she needs to obviously keep the winning streak up there so she can get that 50 quid bath once we reopen. I don't know, I can't see if she's joined in tonight, but I'm sure they're on there. A lot of other people will be, but I can't see them. Once you get this round started, I'll be able to see who's on here. All right, so that's the code D82821. Right, okay, that's the code. You've got it on there as well, Steve. Hopefully you've got that now, yeah? Lovely. Right, let's crack on then. So, first round, it's a mystery round, like I said before. So we're going to go straight into that one. Yep, turn it up a bit. A tunage. So we're going to, after the third round, have a little bit of a break, and then you can all tell me off for not doing it right. Right, question one. Which artist's studio was known as The Factory? Okay, so possible four answers. Just pick one of them. So is it Banksy, Andy Warhol, Tracy Emin, or Damien Hirst? That's all you got to do. So don't forget, the quicker you answer it, the more points you're going to get. It's 10 points for every second. So if you answer it with straight away, you're getting the full max points. And you get the fastest finger bonuses, okay? Right, hopefully you got that. Okay, let's see if who got the fastest finger. Andy Warhol was the answer, so 22 of you got that right, and the fastest finger goes to Paige Brindley. There you go. So straight away you're off with a fantastic start there, Paige. 203 points straight in first question. All right, that's good. Right, so question two. How many revolutions per minute do a 7-inch record spin at? Okay, so there's a lot of records, if you can remember them. You millennials may not remember records, but a lot of us do. Tim says, where have you been? I know. Yeah, I'll explain later. Anyway, right, incorrect. 19, if you got it wrong, ladies and gentlemen, the 7-inch record spins at 45, that's what it is. The fastest answer goes to Thicco Paolo, though. Well done, Thicco Paolo. Yeah, sorry if you don't know what records are, guys, but it's stuff we used to listen to music on in the old days on our little record player. And he's got a shop, and yeah, it was great. He used to buy Woolworths, wasn't it? Woolworths always had this little counter with all the records on, top 10. Yeah. Or you even remember recording it on a Sunday on a cassette tape. Definitely won't remember what that is. Yeah, and you have to pause it in between each song, and then you got the full top 40. They were the days. We lived, didn't we, ladies and gents? We lived. They were the days. Anyway, let's crack on with the quiz. I'm late enough as it is. Right, question three. What instrument is in this picture? Okay, so I'm going to send you it now. Just pick up the answer, and don't forget, fastest finger, get the bonus. Right, possible answers are violin, viola, cello, or double bass. Very quick, very, very quick. There you go, Louise, Maya, yeah, you got that. Johnny Depp, he's not up there tonight, is he? I will find him for next week, Louise. Unless the wife knows where Johnny Depp is. No, she doesn't know where he is. We'll get it off next week, Louise. Okay, like I said, I'm rushing around today. Right, answer is cello. Yeah, 25, you got that right. And Tim C was fastest in that finger there. Well done, Tim. What's he saying? I know the instrument because I played it. Very good. Yes, when we open, you can play it again for all our lovely customers. Yeah, we can come down and you can be our first acoustic act. Yes. No, it's on there. I'm going to hold you to that, Tim. Right, actually, fastest finger goes to Tim C, so extra points for you. Question four, two answers in this one I need. Okay, so the United States has four mainland time zones. Which two of these ones are correct, though? Yeah, so Mountain, Western, Central, or Seaboard? Tim says, I'll play the sax. Yeah, I tried to play the sax. I've still got it. I might take it up again one day. We'll see. You can be on a cello and I'll be on the sax then. And James, you boy, can be guitar. We can have a little band going here, ladies and gents. Yeah, the Nags Massive, we'll call us. Yeah. Now, let's think of a different name. Okay, answer was Mountain and Central. They're the time zones. 27 of you got it wrong. Yeah, only four of you got that one right. I wouldn't know anyway. But it's my favourite. It's One Sheet. Yes, well done, One Sheet. It is plenty of points for you again. Is your mum in there tonight? I hope so. Obviously, you're a good lady. And obviously, your sister and that. Hopefully, you're all playing tonight. Don't forget, she has to defend her title this week. So hopefully, she is playing. But if not, we'll catch up with next week. But well done, One Sheet. You've got the fast finger. And the next question five is, what colour are the berries from the rowan tree? Okay, go on then. I'll give you 20 seconds to try and get that one. A rowan tree? Never heard of it, but I'm sure you guys and girls have. We got red, green, yellow, or white. I'll be interested to see what that one is. It is red. All right, only 13 of you got that right. 3-4 it was yellow, 3-4 green, and then 10-4 it was white. But Paige Brindley definitely knew what a rowan tree was, so she got the fastest finger bonus, and the right answer was red. Yes, well done. Question 6, tap the answer for this one, so I need you to type the number. Okay, so put the British sitcoms in order they were first shown, earliest first. Okay, and it's not a number one. I retract that. It is a question. So pick one of them. Oh, I'm not with it tonight, ladies and gents. I'm out. What's going on? I'll have a... See, I'm not even drinking. I've been rushing around. I'm not even drinking. Right, okay. Young Ones would have been first. Hello, Hello in the second. A Red Dwarf, awesome, a third. And then Birds of a Feather. Yeah, so I didn't really like that program. But, yeah, three other three. Hello, Hello. I will say this on advance. Yeah, you won't remember it, millennials, but there you go. Google it. It's a good program. Hello, Hello. Sadly, he died, didn't he? He got a tree fell on him. No, never mind. Good old dog. René, René. Right, question 7. I've stopped doing these impressions. I'm sorry. Name the British tennis player in this picture. Okay, I'm going to send you it now. So just name it. Or her. Bit rude, wasn't it? Name it. It's a her. There we are. So Heather Wilson, Joanna Conton, Katie Balter, or Anna Smith. Here we go. I'll read some of these messages. Yeah, growing trees. That's awesome. Ah, rowan trees, fruit pastels. Of course it was. not. Right, the answer is, it is Joanna Conta. Joanna Conta. Yeah, 14 of you got that one right. 8-4 Heather Wilson. 3-4 it was Katie Boodler. And 4-4 it was Anna Smith. Who's got the fastest finger, though? Let's have a look. Linz. Hello, Linz. Welcome to the quiz. You've got the fastest finger bonus for that one, so well done. Let's have a look. No interesting quiz facts on these ones tonight. Let's have a look. Nice to see you. There's quite a few people in tonight. As you can see, we've got Nana of the Beers back, Ken Boogley, all the way from Birmingham. The Posties. Posties. Which Posties, which Posties are these? Anyway, Professor Quiz Witty. Yeah, they're all back in there tonight. Love it. Again, apologies for being late. I shall crack on because I'm sure you don't want to be hanging around all Friday night waiting for me to do this quiz and you want to do something else. But let's crack on. Question 8. Which Italian city is home of the car manufacturer Fiat? There we are. So is it Turin, Milan, Naples, or Florence? How are you doing that? A little quick slurp. What's going on? No vodka tonight. I'm not with it today. So have a look. Right. Answer was Turin. Yeah, 13 of you got it right. 11 thought Milan. 3 people thought it was Naples, and 1 thought it was Florence. Didn't tell me who the fastest finger was on that one, but that didn't mean you're getting some points anyway, so hey-ho. Right, question 9. Tap the number for this one. This time you tap the number. Okay, what date in April is St. George's Day? Yeah, we just had St. David's Day, but what date is St. George's Day? If you're in England, you're going to care. If you're in Wales, you won't. So, but go for the points. Yes, it's all about... Oh, it's 50-50 on this one. Near enough. Yeah, 15 if you got it wrong. So 15 of you are from Wales, obviously. And 14 who got it right, you're from over the border, I guess. The day is 23rd. Yeah, 23rd of April, St. George's Day. And we won't be celebrating it down here. Yes, but I'm sure you guys up north will be. Yes. So have a look. Fastest finger goes to Ken Boogley. Yes, yes. James is family there from Birmingham. Welcome to the quiz again there, Ken. Thanks for joining us all the way from... down south, is it? Birmingham? Yeah, down that way somewhere. Near Wolverhampton, I've been told, by the way. Let's have a look. Question 9. The 10 even. Which store first opened in Burnt Oak Barnet in 1929? Whoa, Burnt Oak Barnet. Yeah, 29. I've stumped on that one, ladies and gents. Hope you get that one. I'll read some of these messages. Jim says, George was the one who slew the dragon, isn't he? English got that wrong, yes. Is your English, Linz? And you got it wrong. Never mind. We don't celebrate much around here. There we go. Right, answer was Tesco. Yeah, that was the first opened there, saw in 1929 and Burnt Oak in Barnet. Yeah, that's all right. They've got Paolo. Well done for doing your supermarket trivia there. Well done. Have a look. Question 11. Name the England footballer. I don't know why it's all about England tonight, ladies and gentlemen, but hey ho. Hopefully you'll get the answer. So I'll send you the picture now. Oh, good looking chap, that one. Just tell me who this good looking chap is. So is it Phil Neville, Michael Owen, Gary Neville, or Paul Scholes? Yes, I'll read this message as well. Dion Watson. Dion and Sheena, the Posey. Ah, Kyra's mum. Hello, yes. Hello there. Thanks for playing the quiz. Is Kyra in there tonight? Yeah, I'm sure she is. Anyway, we had a chat the other night. It was nice. Across teams, we didn't do it face-to-face because that would just be breaking every COVID regulation, wouldn't it? No, but it was nice to catch up with her. And the rest of the team, obviously. Right, answer was, that was Gary Neville. Yeah, 23, we got that one right. The fastest finger, Furloughed Minds. Hello, Furloughed Minds. Welcome to the quiz. Fastest finger bonus for you. Excellent. Now, don't forget, though, the next question is the evil one. Number 12 is always the evil question. So you've got to have a stab at this one, because if you don't have a go, you lose some points. If you get it wrong, you're losing some points. 100 points, I believe it is. And if you get it right, you get extra points. So happy days, so go for it. So the next question is, who had a number one hit in 1972 with Wishing Well? There we are. Was it Status Quo, Free, CCS, or Blue Mink? Wishing Well, 1972. I believe there's another song called Wishing Well. I was thinking it was something different there. That was Wet, 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 wasn't it? Wishing Well? Yeah. Obviously, it wasn't up there. That's why I was saying it, because I thought it was. But 1972 would have been far too early for Wet, Wet, Wet. So I was going to have a guess. It's Status Quo. No, it's Free. Free. 13 of you got that right. 8 said it was CCS. 4 said Status Quo, like my silly self. And 3-4 Blue Mink. But the fastest finger goes to Tim C. So at the end of the quality song, well done, Tim. End of that round, you are taking the lead. Well done, Tim. So look, so I'm going to tell you where you all are. Oh, no, sorry, Tim, I lied. You were doing all right at the fastest fingers, but by the scores, you're not doing that well, Tim. So next round, fastest fingers and the correct answers. Okay, right, in fifth place is our reigning champions, the Beers, 1,242 points. Just ahead, in fourth place is One Shoot, yes, with 1,285 points. Third place this week is Thicko Paolo, 1,442 points. In second place is Mrs. S. Well done, Mrs. S. 1,519 points. And in first place, I'm thinking this is Team Anzar. They've just changed the name slightly. It is Anzar tonight. 1,552 points. So that keeps you first. That's the first round there, Anzar. Well done. But it is all about getting the points in the next rounds and getting them in there the fastest. So let's crack on. Let's see what the second round's going to be tonight, because I haven't got a Scooby-Doo what it is going to be. Yes, I didn't have a chance to look, let alone start the quiz for you guys and girls on time. But the next round is, drumroll, connections. Okay, we've done this one before. Yeah, connections, you're just basically connected to the next answer and so on and so on and so on. You'll work it out. It's quite fun. Just spot the connection. That's all you got to do. Okay, so question one. Which ITV region makes Coronation Street? Okay, so then the next question will be a connection onto Coronation Street, I assume. Yeah, so is it Yorkshire, Thames, Central, or Granada? Very quick. The Beers will get this. So I've no doubt loves Coronation Street. Of course, it's Granada, yeah. 21 of you said that, so you got it points. 4 thought Central, 2 thought Thames, and 3 thought Yorkshire. Well, you would think Yorkshire, wouldn't you? Yeah. But it isn't. It is Granada. And Paige Brinley, off the bat there, gets the fastest finger bonus. Well done, Paige. Okay, right. If you wonder why I'm looking up, it's just because I've got two screens on and I go here, if you've not seen me do this before, so I'm not just doing this. Anyway, answer this question. What is this iconic fashion item? There we are. I'll send you a picture. So, iconic. Hello. Hey, I scrolled down to get the picture, so you can imagine my surprise when I got down to the yellow skirt. There we are. Woohoo. There we are. So, is it a bubble skirt, a cowl skirt, a mini skirt, or a line skirt? Yep, I'm making the fastest finger bonus in there, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. If the Miami Tornadoes might be playing tonight. Don't forget, them guys are in 9, so they're quite good at this quiz. So hopefully they'll be the next generation leading the country with the brains of Britain. There we are. But I can't see them on there tonight, so they must be playing their PlayStations or Xboxes. Right, the answer was it was a mini skirt. Yeah, 27, you got that one right. 2 of you thought a line skirt. 1 team thought it was a cowl skirt. Tim Cowell skirt. Hey, see what I did there, Tim? Nobody thought it was a bubble skirt, but the fastest finger bonus goes to nobody. So you must have all got it at the same time, which is weird, isn't it? Yeah. Louise Myers, mini skirt connection to Corey. Did Annie Walker wear one? Yeah, no, you're absolutely right. I have no idea what that's about. But yeah, I'll look into that one again. I didn't look into the ribs question from last week. There is 24 ribs, not 19. So I shall need to address that one with Quizbit. Let's have a look. See the next question anyway, see what the connection could be. In what sport would you use an iron, putting, or wedge? Yeah, get the connection for that one. There we are. So is it snooker, curling, golf, or shooting? Oh, very, very, very quick. It was golf, yeah, 28 of you said that. Two thought it was curling, and no one thought snooker, and nobody thought shooting. But the fastest finger goes to Thicco Paolo. Thicco Paolo's back in there with the fastest finger bonus. Well done, Thicco Paolo. Okay. So, question four. What is a person who accompanies another person to social event called? There's a company, an escort, a friend, or a call girl? Well, never had one myself, but I thought it was a chaperone, but it wasn't up there. It is escort. Yeah, well, of course it is. Escort agency. Yeah. 26 of you knew that once. Well done. You've been picking your escorts out there, I guess. Two thought friends, one thought a call girl. I like that person who thought that one. Great minds think alike. nobody. One person thought it was company. Yeah, that's what you're in company. Fastest finger goes to Phil and Annie, the beers. Well done. All the answers have connection at the end of a round. Last question, well, what's the connection? Haley, thank you. Right, my head was spinning trying to work out why I'm talking absolute gibberish tonight. It's because my head's still fuzzy from running around. It's the paint fumes. It's what it is, the gloss. But yes, no, the connection will be at the very end. So if anybody has probably thought that out as well, yes. Thank you very much, Haley. Really appreciate that, actually. Yeah, that's genuine. I really do appreciate it because I couldn't work it out how the connection is. Right, okay. Question five. What is the car going through? So, well, it's a picture. I'm going to send you that. So, what is the car going through? There we go. Something we have a lot of around here. So, the stream, a ford, a river, or a pond? I was just going to say floods. Yeah, that's what that was the comedy factor on that one. But the answer it was a ford. Yes, what is the car going through? It's a ford. Yeah, 23, we got that one right. It's a 3-foot stream, 2-foot river, and 2-foot was a pond. Yes, pond. Okay. Tim C, fastest finger. Well done, Tim. Question six. Put these jeans brands in order of sales in the USA. So biggest first. There we are. So Diesel, Lee, Wrangler, and Levi's. But which one's the biggest first? All right. Oh, that's quite nice, that Diet Pepsi. Coca-Cola, can't say that. So look, it is Levi's was first, so they're the biggest seller, and then Wrangler would be second, third was Diesel Jeans, and then fourth is Lee. Yeah, Lee Jeans. So only four people got this one right, 27 got it wrong. Haley, though, thank you, Haley, for connecting me, well, making me aware of the connection, and you've got the fastest finger on there, so well done. Mandy Evans, did the code change for the quiz? It say play connected. If so, what new code? So yeah, there was a bit of a glitch at the beginning there, Mandy. So I will let you catch up. The new code is this one, okay? Lindsay's just put it on there as well, after days. So yeah, D82821. There we are. So if you can't see that one on the screen, I'll hold it up for a second. I know you guys, James is helping out, he's typed on there, Lindsay Harrison, she's done it as well, so appreciate that. I'm sure Mandy does as well. You'll obviously need to get your fastest finger right in there though, Mandy, because you're going to have to catch up. But sorry, next week I will be on time, ready and waiting for you, all right? This week, my apologies, didn't remember my team name like it usually does, hey-ho. Tim, doesn't matter, you still couldn't, it was Tim C, so it does actually recognise you. Anyway, let's have a crack on for the next question. Question seven, what are you doing if you correct a blurry image? All right, so Tim should know this one. He's a videographer. So the focus, balance, exposure, or vibrancy? If you said focus, you'd be right. It's 29 of you did. Only three people thought it was exposure. Nobody thought vibrancy and nobody thought balance. But the biggest, pipped it there. Well done. You got a fastest figure bonus for you there. Escott Anzar, his team Anzar. Mrs. S. Crisp, but you're playing against each other tonight. Ah, very good, Mrs. S. and Anzai, head to head. Love it, yes. I like a little bit of competition on a Friday night. We haven't got much else to do. And I look forward to these Friday nights as well, ladies and gents. I'm glad you keep playing with me every week. I mean, there's lost a couple of teams tonight. That's probably my fault for being late. So, naughty Chris, naughty Chris. Next week, I will be here right now, like I promise. But anyway, that question, the beer's got the fastest finger bonus. So well done, Phil and Ali. Question eight is a picture one again. So what is this picture? I'm going to send it now. There we go. Yeah, so then do it possible. So what is that picture? Just going to turn this volume up. There we go. We've got to be careful what we play on the music tonight because we got told off by YouTube last week because it was copyright Van Halen. For some reason, we got banned in Syria, Israel, and Jerusalem, I think. James knows. He sent me the link. But yeah, we got banned for a bit. Unbelievable. Warned not to play Van Halen. So we won't be playing Van Halen tonight. I shall be using a different platform to entertain you during the break. But funny, yeah? Got banned from Syria. Happy days. Yeah. Happy days. Right. Answer to that one is Marina. Yeah. 23 if you go right. 2-4 is a dockyard. 5-4 harbour down in the harbour. And 3-4 is a port. Yes. So have a look. Pemsey. Hello, Pemsey. Haven't seen you on there for a while, but welcome to the quiz tonight. And again, sorry for my lateness. Read some of these messages, but you're glad to pleasure. Paige, naughty girl. I'm not reading that out. James. Oh, James has said it was Saran, Iran, Iraq, and North Korea were actually banned from. There you go. Well, hey ho. They obviously don't like good music. Doesn't your personal license cover that? No, it doesn't cover it. No, because we're using YouTube, aren't we? We're not supposed to use any copyrighted material, which is crazy. Hey ho. No, well done, Pemsey, though. Fastest finger bonus for you on that one. Question nine. What was the sweet starburst originally called? Ooh, I know this one. I know this one. Right. Was it Skittles, Opal Fruits, Toffee? Toffees are awesome. Or Pacers? Yeah. It was obviously Opal Fruits. Hopefully all of you guys and girls have got this one. Yes. Every single one of you tonight said Opal Fruits made to make your mouth water. Yes, absolutely brilliant. Again, like Mars bars and stuff, they've changed all the names. Mars hasn't changed, but Snickers was originally Marathon, if you don't know that answer. Are any young ones playing tonight? Yeah, them Snickers you chomp on were called Marathons. Yes, bloody Americans, change everything. Right, okay, question 10. I'm famous for a whore, the Mayflower Museum and the Edison Lighthouse. Where am I? Okay, so I'm going to send you a picture now. Right, so I'm famous for a whore, the Mayflower Museum, and the Eddystone Lighthouse. Where am I? So would you be in Southampton, Weymouth, Portsmouth, or Plymouth? Let's have a look. It was Plymouth. Yeah, 14, you've got that right. Fastest finger bonus goes to Paige Brinley. 8 thought Portsmouth, 9 thought Weymouth, and 2 thought Southampton. Yes, but if you're in Plymouth, famous for a whore. Yes, H-O-E, yes. There we are. Questionable question. Right, question 11. All right, this one is an evil question on this one. So what's the connection? We've got an answer from the 4 possible options. I think it's crashed on this one, then, gentlemen, because all it's saying is what's the connection? I don't know if it's going to give you... it's working now. There we are. So what's the connection from all them questions? Was it trains, boats, planes, or cars? James, Syria. Yes, I knew you said Syria. You've corrected it. Not Syrian. It's Syria. There we are. Right, so the connection should have been all about cars. They're all cars in them questions, apparently. Work that one out. Miniskirt. I don't know. I don't know. But that's the answer we're looking for. 25, you got it right, so that's great. And my good old buddy there, one sheets. I've got the fastest finger bonus on that one, so you don't lose any points because that was the evil question. One early on this round for some reason. Only 11 questions. There we are. Right, so in 5th place is one sheet. You've now scored 1,678. That's respectable. If you said anything above 1,000, I'm not going to give you a meh. You're going to get a thumbs up from me. Anything over 1,000. You're all really good good scores tonight, ladies and gents. All of you. 4th place is Baby Shark Doo 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 Doo. Baby Shark, do. I mean, yes, there we are. You now place fourth. 1769. Is anything to do with that song, Baby Shark? I'm sure it is. Third place to Beers, 1878. These are cracking scores, ladies and gentlemen. I can tell you that. Second place, back by the original name, the Pecks, 1918 points. Just above, though, is Nana. Yeah, hello, Nana. Yes, we can't wait to see you back on table five. But yeah, well done. You've smashed that round. 1,938 points. Fantastic. Keep it up, Nana, and you can have that 50 quid bar tab when we reopen. But you've got to keep winning every week, so join in every week, which I know you do. Okay, right. So moving on to the next round. That's how it works, isn't it? Round after round. It is going to be technology. Yes. I don't think we've had technology before. Actually, that's a fact. We haven't had technology before. Well, I hope we'll see what it's like with technology. You know, Samsungs and Amstrads and PCs, all that sort of stuff. I'm sure it's going to be about that. But let's have a look. I'm quite intrigued to play this round now. Right. Question one in is in 1852, American Alicia Graves Otis produced the first successful safety what? Okay, so what did 1852 there? All right, well, that lady invented the elevator. Yes, and 11 people have got it right. 4 said escalator and 5 for conveyor belt and 34 as a safety barrier. But no, yeah, fastest finger bonus with elevator goes to Mo Lester. Do you know, I'm going to start reading these things a little bit slower. Mo Lester. I'm going to call you Mo. Right. Alicia Graves Otis founded the Otis Elevator Company in New York of 1852. Yes, there we are. America, the only place where they actually have escalators up to a gym. Yeah, well, that's typical Americans, isn't it? Let's have a look. Right. Question two. How many months did it take the Perseverance Mars rover to get to the planet Mars? Right, I'll say that again. How many months did it take the Perseverance Mars rover to get to Mars, basically? There we are. So type in the number. Perseverance. James, I'm not reading that. If you can read it, it's over here. It could be up here, it could be down here. Depending on what you're using. Terrible, terrible joke. Right, okay, 25, you got it wrong, ladies and gentlemen. 8 got it right, though, so well done, you get some extra points there. The answer was 7. Yeah, it took 7 months to get to Mars. Is it still there? It probably broke down by now, I guess. It ran out of some batteries, unless it was using Duracell. There we are. Fastest finger, though. Well done, Thicco Paolo. There we are. Question three. Right, which first electric sewing machine was invented by which company in 1889? Okay, so the first electric sewing machine was a Singer Brother Jones of Vanguards. Okay, it was Singer. Yeah, Singer was the first sewing machine there. 26 of you got it spot on. 3 thought Brother, 2 thought Jones, and 1 thought it was Vanguard. Vanguard, no, it wasn't, though. The Beers. Well done. Obviously, you know, I'm going to spell sewing down in socks and stuff like that. You've got a faster finger bonus there, Phil and Ollie. Or to you guys, the Beers. Yeah, right. Question four. It's a picture on this one. So what is this vital piece of equipment? So I'm going to send you the picture now. Just tell me what this vital piece of equipment is. There we are. Possible. So it's a PC hard drive, electric meter, flight recorder, or a laser spirit level. Okay, very fast. I'm assuming that's a flight recorder. Yes, there we are. So it's 23, also known as the black box. But I don't know why it's called black box, because it is red. Yeah, somebody can tell me the interesting fact of why it's called a black box. Haley says, I still have the Singer table in pub. Do you really, Haley? I'll get you in there, Haley. Yeah, so, I shall send you some clothes to amend for me. I guess I have to bring it down once you visit. She's visiting, by the way, England, because she's allowed, because she's working now from the 12th. She's back at work. I'm thankfully not back at work just yet. So I have a lot of time on my hands from the 12th. So we might do a few more quizzes, eh? But anyway, yes, she's back at work, and I'm hopefully going to be back soon. Actually, we want to get you through the doors again, and we can have a good chat face to face. Anyway, right, moving on. Mo Lester. Well done, Mo Lester. Yeah, you got a faster finger on that one. Mo, hey Mo, how many options are available in Facebook for liking or showing your response to a post? I think it needs a few more. And I do believe Apple today released 217 new emojis. Yeah, apparently. That's, where are you going to put 217 emojis? I don't know. I suppose you have got quite a lot when you open things like flags and plants and things like that when you're so. But yeah, if you've got an Apple phone, you've got 217 new emojis. So, right, the answer was 6. Right, okay, so options for 6. Yeah, you've got the smiley face, sad face, caring, heart, like, angry. Anyway, the answer was 6. Can't remember what the other one is. Mrs. Smith, though, got the fastest finger bonus for you there. Well done. Question 6. Which two are types of cooker? So which two are types of cooker? There we are. So we've got glass plate, induction hob, ceramic hob, or turbo. I cannot be here. Haley just said you can be a chauffeur. Not a chance. And it's because I was C, by the way, Haley. Chauffeur. Corrected me last week. Let's have a look. It is induction hob and ceramic hob was the answer we're looking for. Fastest finger bonus, however, goes to... Wait, you didn't tell me, but 19 of you got it right. So on this one, which fruity emoji is often used to represent a bottom? Is it? Oh, of course it is. Yeah, so which fruity emoji is often used to represent the bum, the bottom, the backside, or in America, the penny? Yes, but what is it? Which fruity emoji? You all thought about that one. It was a peach. Of course it was. Peachy. Yeah, 27, you got that one right. 2 for apricot. Yeah, it could have been, couldn't it? Apricot, a bit like a peach. 3 for plum. And 1 for cherry. I suppose either one could look like a bum. If you're that way inclined to looking, I don't know. Yeah, they'll call you cherry bum. Let's have a look. Fastest finger though goes to Pemsey. Well done, Pemsey. Fastest finger bonus for you. Question 8 is a picture on this one. So what is this icon? We'll send you a picture now. Boom. Should be with you. And just give me the answer on that one. So what is this icon? Don't actually show me there. Peck said, you're really scraping the bottom of the barrel with these questions. Yeah, I think that was a bum question. There you go. Let's have a look. Answer was, drum roll, it was Bluetooth. Yeah, that's the sign for Bluetooth. All 32 of you got that one right. Ginger Andy. Oh, Girandi, yeah. I thought it was either Ginger Randy. But no, it's Ginger Andy. Yeah, Ginger Andy got the fastest finger bonus there. Well done. Question 9. Put these electrical appliances in order of invention. Earliest first, please. So is it the pop-up toaster, washing machine, the vacuum cleaner, dishwasher? Which order? So earliest first. Well, it's quite refreshing having a drink out here. I need to cut down because I've put a stone on, believe it or not. Ladies and gentlemen, you can't see below this level, but... Yeah, so I used to be 11 and a half, now I'm 12 and a half. That's bad. Yes. To the gym I go once it opens. Quite right. So vacuum cleaner would have been first. That was the earliest. Second place would have been washing machine. And then third was dishwasher. And then fourth was a pop-up toaster. I would have thought that was a lot earlier than that. But nope, that's the order we needed. Only one team got this one right, and that's Nana. Well done, Mandy Evans. Mandy said, hello. Hello, Andy and Mandy. Yeah, I can't read these. I need some glasses. I really need to go to the opticians. Anyway, Nana, well done on that one. Fastest finger bonus for you. Question 10. Which mobile phone company has produced models called StarTAC, V220 and SLVR? Okay. So, is Motorola, Samsung, Nokia or Huawei? Huawei? Does anybody actually know how to pronounce that properly? Is it Huawei or Huey? Does anyone care? No, I'll move on. Let's have a look. Show answers. It is Motorola. 16 of you there. You got that right. 2 for Samsung, 4 said Nokia, and 11 for that Huawei or Howie, whatever it is. The fastest finger is Davey Grifter. Well done, Davey. Welcome to the quiz. So I don't even play in all nines, but just for fastest finger. So well done, Dave. So, right, question 11. Type the number on this one. So which model Apple iPhone was the first not to have a headphone socket? Okay, so on this one. So which model Apple phone was the first not to have the headphone socket? So the iPhone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's the way to do it, okay? Obviously, didn't need explaining. Okay, right. The answer is the first, it was 7. Apple 7. Yeah, Apple phone 7. I was sure it was had a headphone socket, but there you go, obviously not. But then again, we know Quizbit don't always get these questions right, do they? With the ribs and then the £1 million and all that sort of stuff. But hey, it's a bit of fun. Little old wine drinker me finally gets the fastest finger bonus. So she is playing tonight, our winner from last week. So yeah, keep it up there, little old wine drinker me. And Quizbees if they're playing. And yeah, we'll see how you win this week. Like I said, 50 quid bar tab. There you go. Keep it going. Probably cost you 50 quid in petrol to get here, but there you go. So it's winner-winner. You get your money back. Let's have a look. Right, evil question. That's number 12. So which the Oric 1 was released in 1983, but what is it? So the Oric 1 was released in 1983, but what is it? Or is it? Is it a calculator, a digital watch, a palm computer, or a home computer? Yes, and even if you Google it, it's taking your time, so you don't get as many points, is it? So I'd have to Google that one. No idea what the Oric 1 is, but I'm about to find out. It is a home computer. Yeah, that's what an Oric 1 is. 10 of you said a calculator, 2 thought it was a digital watch, and 6 thought it was a palm computer. So yeah, only 15 of you are going to get some extra points on that one. Never mind, so about next round. Dwayne Dibley, yes, second best name tonight. Yes, obviously, one sheet, and I'm putting Molester, you've put down a third tonight. You're down a third. Now, Dwayne Dibley's took over, only because I love Dwayne Dibley. You never know. Gandams. His little lunchbox. It's a reference to Red Dwarf. I've just said that. And Dwayne Dibley is cat. It's his alter ego, isn't it? But, yeah, Dwayne Dibley, fastest finger bonus on that one. Well done. Love it. So, right, at the end of that round, in fifth place is Anzar. You've got 1,283 points. Second place is fourth place is Dwayne Dibley. It's 1,285 points. Third place is De Beers, 1,355. Second place tonight is Little Old Wine Drinker Me for that round. So, champions from last week, 1,452. That's respectable. But just ahead, in first place, is Thicko Paolo. You've got 1,475 points there, Thicko Paolo. Awesome. There we are. Well, let's see what the next round is going to bring for you. See if you get that one in the bag, eh? Right, so the next round is going to be, when it works, picture this. Right, so basically it's just pictures. So I'm going to send you 12 pictures. You'll get 4 possible options and just pick one of them, all right? That's as easy as it can be. Yes, I don't need to repeat that. It's a picture question, everyone, because it is a picture question round. There we are. Okay, so there we go. Question one. Name the sports brand. There we are. I'll send you that little image across. Change it up from picture. So what brand is that? There we are. So is it Slazenger, New Balance, Puma, or Nike? Ooh, I would have thought there was a bit of a controversy on that one. Let's have a look. It was Puma. Yeah, didn't Slazenger have a cat as well? I'm not sure. Nobody thought Slazenger anyway. All 31 of you said Puma. One thought New Balance. Lindsay Harrison, no break tonight. Is that this is the third round, isn't it? At the end of the third round, we have a break. But we'll have a break at the end of this round, okay? We'll go get yourself a drink and have a cigarette, whatever you want to do. But we shall crack on with this round because we've started now. So started, so I shall finish. Yes. Tim, yes, we can have a wipey bum break, yes, in a minute, but we'll do this round first. Question two, what is this piece of medical equipment? So I'm going to send you a picture now. There we are. There we are, send you that one. Lovely, Linz, yeah, sorry, you thought it was fourth round as well. I thought it was fourth round there, but yeah, I'm sure it's just the third, isn't it? We shall have a go at this one anyway. Right, the answer for this one, it was a defibrillator. 19, we got that one right. 2 thought it was a vital signs monitor. Nobody thought it was an anesthesia monitor. And 12, so it was a cardiac monitor. But the fastest finger goes to Ken Bogley. Yes, well done, Ken. No, we're not right. So question three, name the chaser in the picture. So it's a chaser off the TV. Oh, who is it? There we are. He's a new one, isn't he? He's a new one, this guy. I quite like him. I don't know what your opinion is, but is it Mark Lebeth, Paul Cena, Sean Wallace, or Dara Ennis? It is, of course, Dara Ennis, yeah. New to the chase, but he's a clever guy. Yeah, he's very, very clever. 26 of you got that one. Right, Louise Myers, yeah, where's the break? I know I went a bit over. We'll be back in a minute. We'll do the break, okay? So you can offer an extra wee break. Right, let's have a look. Grifter, well done, Grifter. You fastest finger bonus for you. Yeah, so 26 said Darren Ennis. Four of you thought it was Sean Wallace. One thought Paul Cena. And two thought it was Mark Lebeth. Which new. He's the beast, isn't he, that one? So which British city is in this picture? So I'm going to send you that now. So which British city is in this one? Should be a big clue there. My wife goes quite often. She loves it. I'm not telling you where it is because Johnny will get it, but the clue is in the picture. Of course, it is Sheffield. That was the Crucible, wasn't it? All 29 of you got it right. Two said Swindon. Two thought it was Liverpool, and nobody thought it was Northampton. Pemsey, though. Well done. Fastest finger bonus for Pemsey. Right, question five. Name the cartoon dog. So which cartoon dog is this? Yeah. Send you that over now. Easy peasy, a lemon squeezy, that one. Right, let's have a look. It is, of course, Scrappy Doo. Yeah, let me at him. Let me at him. Yeah, good old Scrappy. 26, you're going to spot on. One thought Clifford. Don't know who Clifford is. It's Clifford. It's Clifford. Six thought Scooby Doo. Little bit small for Scooby Doo, but never mind. And nobody thought it was Hong Kong Phooey. Yes, of course it wasn't. It was Scrappy Doo. The BSO, fastest finger bonus for you. Question six. What chocolate bar is in this image or picture or picture? Yeah, so what chocolate? Oh, lovely that one. Yes, I can actually make this. It's really easy. It's obviously a crunchy bar, but the sweet which you can make is Cinder Toffee. Very easy to make. Yeah. Remember when you used to go to the seaside and get it in a big bag and you used to stink everywhere in the car all the way home and you used to fall onto somebody's lap and you can never get it off because it's so sticky. Right, it was a crunchy. Like I said, all 33 of you got that one right. One sheet, fastest finger bonus. Let's have a look. Question seven. What is the double act in this picture? So I'm going to send you that now. So where was the double act? Love it. So is that Little and Large? Is that Cannon and Ball? Is it Mark and Wise? Or is it Mike and Bernie Winters? And you've all answered it really fast, so I'm assuming you're going to all say Cannon and Ball. Of course it was. Rock on, Tommy! Yeah. Yes, 31 of you got it right. Only two for you for Mark and Wise. Yeah, fair enough. Could have been, but it wasn't. Again, one sheet. Plenty of points for you tonight there, one sheet. You're on it. On it. Loving it. So, right, question eight. Which canal island would you find this landmark? So, which channel island canal? Hey, again with my pronunciations. There we are. So, which channel island would you find this landmark? Well, while you're doing that one, I'm going to read some of these questions. Clifford the Big Red Dog. Thank you, Lindsay. I do remember it now. It was the back of my mind. I do know. So, right, it is Jersey. Yes, 10 people said that one. Six said Shersack, seven for Aldenry, and 10 for Guernsey. Think of Paolo, though, fastest finger bonus for you. Let's have a look. Have a little thing. Let's read some of these messages. We've been weird as it was talking to Chris. Yeah, there we go. See, I can read these and do it at the same time. So this one, name the egghead in the picture. So egghead, I'm sure it's not Humpty Dumpty. Egghead. There we are. Never watched Eggheads. My nanny used to watch Eggheads. Oh, bless her. She used to every day religiously watch it. Too complicated for me. So it is Judith Keppel, or Keppel. 31, you got it right. So you're obviously up on your quizzes, TV quizzes, that is. One for Lisa Thiel and one for Pat Gibson. And nobody thought it was Beth Webster. Yeah, why would we? Beth Webster, get rid of her. Thick old Paolo, again, fastest finger bonus. Yes, Louise Myers. I know Johnny Deppy will be up after the break if I can find it. I'll find out where she's put him. She's probably hiding it because it's got Barbarella on there. Well done, football Paolo. No, fastest finger bonus for you. Question 10. Name the American president in this image. Or picture. There we are. So, name the American president for that one. So, is it Gerald Ford, Jimmy Carter, Ronald Reagan, or Richard Nixon? Yeah, Lindsay, sparkles. I could put it on after the break. So, yeah, I will put it on, I promise. Okay, Gerald Ford. Yeah, 19, we got that right. He thought it was Jimmy Carter. 3 thought Ronald Reagan. And 3 thought it was old Richard Nixon. Same room as Johnny Depp. I've been in the same room. You've been in the same room as Johnny Depp. Well, that's an interesting quiz fact, that, Lindsay. I like that one. So, look. Right, question 11. Name the theatre production. There we are. Name this one. So, I'm going to send you a picture of that. Was the room that is court case? Hopefully not. He didn't go to watch that one. I'm sure it was before that. Anyway, here's your possible answers to that one. So, is it Frozen, The Lion King, The Jungle Book, or Shrek? Let's have a look. It is Shrek. Yeah, donkey. In the morning, I'm making waffles. There we are. 22, you got it right. 4 thought it was Jungle Book. 4 thought it was Lion King. And 3, hey, I'm Bamba. My little cat there. I haven't seen her all day. 3 thought Frozen. But Tim C, fastest finger bonus for you, Timmy. There we are. Surprise. So what's Tim on about here? There's something going on. There's something going on in the chats. Come on, Bo Derek. I know I did say that last week, Dion. I said Bo Derek. Next week, it's a promise. Definitely a promise, a promise, a promise. Bo Derek will be up there. And I'll have his Spidey jacket there and I'll be on time. Right, question 12, either one. Which artist painted this picture? I'm going to send you the options and the picture. And just tell me, was it Henry Miller, J.S. Lowry, Francis Bacon, or Lucian Froude? So Froude. Okay, very fast. But did you get it right? Because it was 26. If you did get it right, it's S. Lowry. Yeah, L.S. Lowry. One team thought it was Francis Bacon, so sadly you're going to lose some points on that one. 5 because it said Lucian Froude, or Froude. You're going to lose points as well, sorry. And one said Henry Moore. Another team to lose 100 points. Not a problem, though, because you can make them back next round. That's all it's about. Grifter, though, fastest finger bonus on table 12, so you're going to get extra points on that one, mate. Well done. So, at the end of that round, in fifth place is Quizbees. Well done, Quizbees, 2029. I see Pippin, your daughter. See, you're cleverer than her, you see, even though you're in the same house. It's yeah, well done, Quizbees. Fourth place, The Beers, 2,042 points. And third place is Arrow Pecks, 2,119 points. Smashing it with Mrs. Smith in second now, 2,178 points. And in first place is Professor Quiz Witty. Yeah, well done, Professor Quiz Witty. You've got 2,180 points to be feel proud of during this break. Okay, so we'll have the break now. But yeah, while doing that, I'll play a little bit of music. We'll see if YouTube shuts down tonight. Hopefully not. Yeah, it's a bit miserable when to do that, isn't it? But shall we have a bit of, is that Journey? I think that is Journey. Love it. Right, you can chill out that one. And we're back in 8:35, yeah? Cool. Enjoy Journey. Thank you. There we are. Sparkly jacket at the ready, ladies and gentlemen. I said I'd put it on tonight. I can't find Bo Derek. I didn't have any pictures of Bo Derek. Sorry, Lynch. And I couldn't find Barbarella. And I can't find Johnny Depp. So what are we going to do? So, what's that? Louis said, no vodka. Rats, no. He said, water this evening now. No, Pepsi. I'm on water. Right. Anyway, let's crack on with this lovely quiz. Get down there. I'm just going to put this back into full mode. There we are. Actually, I need to just adjust this computer, ladies and gentlemen. I'm just going to do this. There we are. That's better. I messed it up that time. There we are. Right, so what's the next round going to be, ladies and gents? Let's have a look. It is... Okay, landmarks. Okay, I don't know if we've done this one before, ladies and gents. Not sure. But hey... It is landmarks, and Lindsay Harrison said, "Here it comes." That's better. Yes, it is. There we are. Better. I need a red one, I think, or a yellow one. So if anyone's got one, want to lend me, feel free to pass it up through the window. I shall use my little hook system to get my mail. All right. So everyone's got a sparkly jacket, red, yellow. We'll do a mix up every week with different jackets. How's that? So what is the name of the highest peak in New Zealand? So in New Zealand, what is the highest peak? Is it Mount Cook, Roy's Peak, Mount Tasman, or Maida Peak? Paul Roberts, woo, yeah. Like it. Hey, I don't know why I wear these guys for you. Just wear it for you guys. You know, it's really tight. It's how tight it is. And I've got a jumper on tonight. Look, it's a bit cold. Like I'm decorating, so I'm letting all the fumes out. Answer was Mount Cook. Yes, 17 of you said that one. James Cook, obviously, in reference to that one. Three people said Roy's Peak. 7 thought it was Mount Tasman, and 5 thought it was Mitre Peak, but no, Mount Cook. And the posties, well done, the posties. Fastest finger straight off for you. Extra bonus points. Okay, question 2. 2 answers in this one. So, famous for its high salt content that allows you to float, the Dead Sea has shores on which 2 countries? So, the Dead Sea is on which 2 of them? Israel, Jeddah, Jordan, or Ankara? Jeddah? One of them. Well, that's 2 of them, actually. You've got to pick 2, haven't you? Okay, very, very quick. You didn't even let me have a sip of my water there. But it was Israel and Jordan. Yeah, so the shores of them two is where you'd find the Dead Sea. 24 of you got it right. 9 got it wrong. Dave Grifter, however, got the fastest finger bonus on that question. So well done, Dave. Right, question 3. In which U.S. city is this arch? So I'm going to send you a picture. And just tell me, where would you find this arch? Which U.S. city? So is it Branson, St. Louis, Kansas, or Springfield? Well, you're all thinking about it. You're taking the full 20 seconds near enough there. The answer is St. Louis. Oh, we've got a message. St. Louis, I've just turned my phone on as well. Thank you. I've got everyone's messages of concern. I've just noticed when I was on a break, I should have said thank you for your concern. I'm fine. There was nothing wrong. It's just one of them days. I'm going to turn it down because you're all probably going, what's going on? There you go. Turn it down. I'll reply to all of you later, okay? Fastest finger bonus, and that one goes to the pecs. Well done, the pecs. Question 4. In which country would you find the highest waterfall in the world, Angel Falls? So which country is Angel Falls? Is it Angola, South Africa, Morocco, or Venezuela? Well, that was very quick. You'd find it in Venezuela. Yeah, 15 if you got that one right. 13 if you thought South Africa. 2 thought Morocco. And 3 thought Angola. But the fastest finger bonus goes to good old Ginger Andy. Yes, it could be Gin Randy. Ginger Andy. Yeah, Ginger Andy. Yeah, fastest finger bonus for you. Well done. Question 5. Which Bund is a landmark in which city? The Bund is a landmark in which city? So is it Shanghai, Hanoi, Jakarta, or Tokyo? Tokyo. Which one is it? I don't know if I know it's Hanoi, right? Maybe not, but it wasn't that one anyway. It was Shanghai. Yeah, only 9 of you. 9 thought it was at Hanoi or Hanoi. 7 thought Jakarta, and 7 thought it was Tokyo. But fastest finger bonus goes to Paige Brindley. Well done, Paige. Let's have a look. Right, question 6. Where is the landmark tower? So this landmark, I'll send you a picture, but where is it? Okay. So, yeah, you should have it now. I'll send you the answers. So is it in Dubai, Qatar, Bahrain, or Abu Dhabi? Abu Dhabi, yes. It is Abu Dhabi, yes, I knew it was. Yeah, 10 of you did get it right. 2 thought it was Bahrain, 7 thought it was Qatar, and 14 thought it was Dubai. Fastest finger bonus, though, again, goes to Dave Grifter. Well done. He's after that tab. Let's have a look. So question 7. Durdle Door is a natural limestone arch in which English county? There we are. So Durdle Door is a natural limestone arch in which English county? So is it Devon, Cornwall, Wiltshire, or Dorset? Never heard of that one, but if you had heard of it, it is in Dorset. Yeah, so 11 of you got that one right. 8 of you thought it was in Wiltshire, but no, sadly not. 7 thought Cornwall, and 6 thought it was Devon. But the fastest finger bonus on question 7 goes to Paige. Oh, Paige. Let's have a look. Question eight. Queen Elizabeth's main London residence is in what famous landmark? So is it Buckingham Palace, Kensington Palace, Windsor Castle, or Clarence House? Yeah, so Queen Elizabeth's main London residence is in which famous landmark? Don't know this one myself. Yeah. Well, I don't know what happened there, ladies and gentlemen. We went into minus seconds there. I haven't ever seen it go into minus figures before on the countdown from 20. Maybe it didn't come through with your devices. We'll see. Anyway, I'll show you the answers. No, 19 got it right. It said Buckingham Palace, and 1 thought Kensington Palace, 8 thought Windsor Castle, 3 thought Clarence House. But the fastest finger goes to the Pecks. Well done. And I really don't know how you've got minus figures on the countdown. But hey, here's what it is. You get minus points. Whoever answered it within a second over. Never mind. Question 9. I need 2 answers on this one. The highest Neville Lake in the world, Lake Titicaca, has a border in which 2 countries running through it? I'm not pronouncing any of them again, so you can read it and just answer the questions. Okay, so Peru, Bolivia, Chile, or Uruguay? So which 2 of them? Okay, very quick. It's Peru and Bolivia. Bolivia, I can pronounce that one, so I can't work out what the hell that question actually said, but hopefully you did. Only 11 did, 22 got it wrong. But the fastest finger bonus goes to one sheet. Yes, good old one sheet. So, question 10. Where is this Buddha building? Okay, so where's this Buddha building? It was a very, very nice looking building, in fact. Let's see where it is. Is it in Thailand, Malaysia, Vietnam, or Myanmar? Myanmar, Myanmar. Bruce, you have bully moments. Myanmar. There we are. We'll see anyway. I'm sure it's Thailand. Of course it is. Yeah, 19, you said Thailand, so you get the points there. 14 thought it was Malaysia, 6 thought Vietnam, and 3 thought Myanmar. Yeah, fastest finger bonus goes again to one sheet. He's after his sister's prize. Hey, sibling rivalry. I like that. Give him a clip, Gil. Yeah, sort him out. Kids fighting amongst themselves. Terrible. Old enough to know better. Yeah, no, well done, one sheet, though. We'll be more than happy to see you in Wrexham. We'll show you the sights. It's a lovely place. Right, question 11. What's the tallest dam in the world? What is the name of the dam completed in Black Canyon in 1937? That's a tricky one, isn't it? Yeah, the tallest dam in the world. What is the name of the dam completed in Black Canyon in 1937? It was Hoover. Yeah, Hoover Dam. 27, you got that right. I've actually done a skydive over Hoover Dam. I don't know if you wanted to know that one, but it's a fact, a trivia fact of all things. It was great. I loved it. Don't like heights, so I can't climb a ladder, but I can jump out of a plane. Work that one out. 2 fought Hungry Horse, 3 fought Yellowtail, and nobody fought Shasta. Fastest finger bonus, though, Haley. Well done, Haley, all the way from Stoke. Yes, we'll mention Stoke there. Even though Middlesbrough is above Stoke, I can't say anything more about that, because he'll tell me off next time I speak to him. Which unlucky. Up the borough. Up the borough. There we are. Right, evil question. What exactly is the landmark Big Ben? There we are. So is it a clock, a tower, a bell, or a spire? Yeah, be careful of this one, though. So what's the landmark Big Ben? Is it a clock, a tower, a bell, or a spire? Okay, yes, 19 of you got it right. It said bell. That is absolutely spot on. 5 thought it was a tower, 8 thought it was a clock, and nobody thought spire. But no, it's actually the Big Ben is the bell in the actual tower. So yeah, so there we are. Evil question. Ooh, I love them. Right, so at the end of that one, Nana is now in 5th place. Poor Nana, not to worry though. It's all about next round. You got 1,423 points. 4th place now is one sheet, 1,469 points. 3rd place is Thicko Paolo. You got 1,476 points. Second place is the biggest, is 1,561 points. But in first place on that round is the Pecks. Yay, go Pecks. 1,781 points. Get in there. So you've got to put all these points together, though. That's how you win. You're supposed to win in the rounds, doesn't matter. We're going to see what happens in the next ones, all right? But yeah, well done. Good scores on that one. So let's move on to round six. There we are, round six. So this one is an odd one out. So can you spot the odd one out? I don't think we've done this one before. And this is the last round. You know, I've done quite quick tonight, haven't we? Even though I was late, work that out. How has it gone quick when I was late? I don't know. But anyway, let's have a look. Who wants to win tonight? So odd one out. Which book is the odd one out of this list? So I'm going to send you four. So which one's the odd one out? So you've got Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, Kidnapped, Casino Royale, or Moonraker? Which one is odd one out? Let's go. Yeah. It's a bit random now, isn't it? All right, it's Kidnapped. Eight of you got it right. Everyone thought Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. I would have said that as well. Hopefully it's going to give me a quiz fact exactly why it's the odd one out. But yeah, 24 of you went for Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, which I would have. But nobody went for Casino Royale. No one went Moonraker. Yeah, Bond, Kidnapped. Dwayne Dibley. Yes, here we go. Dwayne Dibley got it right, though. The quiz fact is Kidnapped is a book by Robert Louis Stevenson. All the rest are books by Ian Fleming. There we go. That's the way it works. Apparently, he did he read Chee Chee Bang Bang? God. No, of course he didn't. Let's have a look. Kidnaps. Move on. Question two. Which we'll get it to work. Sorry, I'll just pause there a little bit. So which of these is not a geometrical terminology referring to a part of a circle? Okay, so is it chord, an arc, a net, or radius? Yeah, it's easy that one, isn't it? Well, if you don't know it, it's not really easy. Silly thing to say, Chris. Okay. It is a net. Yes, arc, chord, radius. Yeah, so 19 of you got it right. One said radius, one for arc, and 12 for it was chord. Linz, though, fastest finger bonus for you, Linz. Well done, Linz. Okay, so question three. Which of these is not the name of an apostle in the Bible? Apostle? So is it Philip, Daniel, Simon, or Andrew? Or is there not an apostle? Well, that was a bit of an impossible question, that wasn't it? An apostle question? Oh, that's terrible. The jokes aren't getting any better week on week, ladies and gentlemen. I'm running out of them. That's why. It's been like 38 weeks. Let's have a look. Daniel is not apostle. Six of you got it right. Well, 15 of you thought it was Daniel, Philip, and seven for Simon. It's five for Andrew. Ginger Andy, though, fastest finger. You got that one. Well done, fast finger bonus, that is. Okay, question four. Two answers in this one. So which two are the most expensive properties in the UK Monopoly board? So the UK Monopoly board. So which one two aren't the most expensive? So Oxford Street, Mayfair, Park Lane, or Regent Street? Okay, the two is Regent Street and Oxford Street. Yeah, they're not the most expensive. So Park Lane, obviously, and Mayfair. I think they're the purple ones, aren't they? It's before you get to... Pasco, yeah, I think that's right. I haven't played for a while. 23 of you got it right. 11 got it wrong, sadly. But Linz, yes, you've got a fastest finger bonus in that one. Little quiz fact, Regent Street would cost you £300. Oxford Street would cost £300 as well. Park Lane is £350. And Mayfair is £400. That's the quiz fact. Yeah, I'll be digging out our boards in a minute just to make sure Chris isn't lying to you. But it wouldn't be me, would it? It'd be Quizbit. Yes, I'd just present this thing. Anyway, moving on to question five. Which of the following is not born in India? So which of the following was not born in India? So Paddy Ashdown, Sue Barker, George Orwell, or Jonah Lumley? Jonah Lumley? Jonah, oh, I was going to say Jonah Lomu there. Lately says Jonah Lumley. Again, off the spec savers. Oh, wait, two glasses. Right, Sue Barker. Okay, his father was not born in India. It's Sue Barker. 16, we got it right. 12 thought Paddy Ashdown, 4 thought George Orwell, and 1 thought was Joanna Lumley. Paige Brinley, however, gets the fastest finger bonus on that question. Okay, so question six. Which of these is not a UK Cadbury chocolate brand? Okay, so which one? So Picnic, Toffee Crisp, Crunchy, or Curly Whirly? We all love a Curly Whirly. It's not a UK Cadbury chocolate. Can't think of that one. Okay, full 20 seconds to answer that one. It is a Toffee Crisp. 18 of you got it right. Well done. 7 thought picnic. I was going. I was more swayed towards picnic. 1 thought crunchy, and 6 thought curly whirly. But don't can't rate it's toffee crisp. Don't make them. So, Mrs. S, well done, Mrs. S, smashing it. Fastest finger bonus for you. Okay, question 7. Who is the odd one out in this one? So, pick them. So we've got Prince Charles, Prince Andrew, Prince Anne, or Prince William. So who is the odd one out? Charles, Andrew, Anne, or William? Well, Prince Charles, yeah, Princess Anne, isn't it? No. It is Prince William. Okay, 15 if you got it right. 14 said Princess Anne, said 3 thought it was Prince Andrew, and nobody thought Prince Charles. I was going towards once Prince and the rest of once Princess and the rest of Princes. I don't think that's a quiz fact. One sheet knew the answer quickest. William is a grandchild of the Queen. So William is a grandchild of the Queen. Okay, that's how you work the odd one out. I prefer Prince Anne, to be fair. There we are, then. All right, no worries. I couldn't work it out myself anyway, so hopefully you got that one right. Move on to question 8. Which number is the odd one out in this one? So I'm going to send you that. So which one's the odd one out? You got 3, 13, 23, or 33? 33. So which one's the odd one out? You're all taking your time on this one, ladies and gents. You want the extra bonuses. Well, again, that's what it's about, isn't it? Okay, so the answer was 33. 45, you got this one right. 13 said 13. 13 said 13. 7 said 23, and 7 said 3. Little old wine drinker me, well done. I'm sure this is a mathematical question. That's why I didn't get it, because I was crap at maths at school. I didn't actually get a grade on that one. The others are prime numbers. Yes, there we are. See, I didn't do that bad at school. I'm only joking. But yeah, no, it's prime numbers, them ones. Fastest finger bonus, as I said, little old wine drinker me, our winner from last week. Obviously, in competition with her brother, sibling rivalry. And then the Quizbees is going to give them both a slap. Yes, as we talked before, because Quizbees is the parent. Yes, our parents. I don't know who's playing tonight. It might be Skill. Let's have a look. Right, next question. Which Disney character is the odd one out in this one? So I'm going to send you them. So you've got Simba, Jasmine, Nala, and Scar. So which one of them Disney ones is the odd one out? Yep, I know you're probably watching lots of Disney Plus lately. WandaVision finished tonight. Absolutely amazing. If you haven't seen WandaVision from the beginning, watch it. It's a bit weird to start with. You've got to get your head around it, but it was very, very good watch. A bit sad, but yeah. It's good, anyway. WandaVision, Disney Plus. Right, answer is Jasmine, 27, you got it right. 1 said Simba, 2 thought Nala, 2 thought Scar. Rebel Scum, back in the game. Oh, Rebel Scum. There's no quiz facts, but I can't tell you why she's the odd one out, but I'm sure you guys know it because you got it right, didn't you? Right, question 10. Which is the odd one out from these? So a possible 4. So you've got Androsnes of the Lion, Major Barbera, St. John, and Waiting for Godot. Anyway, just pick which one's the odd one out on that one. Andruckles. I'm sure the books. Let's have a look. Waiting for Godot. 12 of you got that one right. 6 thought it was St. John. 10 thought it was Major Barbera, and 4 thought that Ank, whatever it's called, of the Leon or Lion. She was the other one's Lions. Ah, okay, right, okay, I get that one, Lynn. Thank you very much. Princesses, of course we were. Grifter, no, well done, Grifter. You got a faster finger in that one. Waiting for Gadot was apparently a player by Samuel Beckett. All the others were players by George Bernard Shaw. Yes, love Marvel. Tim, you said love Marvel. WandaVision looked like Bewitched, so I didn't bother. Right, it's a tricky thing. You've got to watch it, though, Tim. Yeah, get your head around it, because it is a little bit like Bewitched, but it's not. You'll find out why it's in that filmed in that way. It moves on, but amazing. Honestly, it was really good. I like Marvel, but there you go. Anyway, let's get back to the quiz. Stop talking, Tim. Yeah, Grifter, you got the fastest finger of bonus for that one, so there's 12 of you got it right. So question 11, which the two of these aren't weapons in a game of Cluedo? So you've got a revolver, a wrench, a screwdriver, or a poison bottle. I'm only joking, Tim. You talk as much as you want. It's me your waffles. But we'll talk about WandaVision later. That's what I meant. Oh, he's so sensitive. He's a cuddle. Fiji's little cheek.
Let's have a look. Yeah, Tim. Lynn said, there we go. Right, okay. The answer were screwdriver and poison ball. They are not weapons in the game of Cluedo. 23 of you got it right. 10 got it wrong, sadly. Tim C, though. I'm not really sorry. Ha, ha, ha. There we go. But you don't need to be sorry, Tim, because you got fastest finger bonus on that one, so that's what it's about. So well done. Let's have a look. Oh, it's question 12, ladies and gentlemen. So this is the decider of this one. So it's the last question of the game as well. It's gone so quick. We're about 15 minutes short tonight of what we usually finish on. And even though I was 5 minutes late, maybe I'm waffling on too fast tonight. But hopefully you still enjoyed it. It's been brief. But yeah, no, we'll be more on time next week. And I'll have some special rounds in for next week. And especially have some board Derek up there, as I promised. But let's do this last question. See who's going to win. Okay, so question 12. Which actress is the odd one out of these four? Okay, so Joanna Lumley, Helen Mirren, Diana Rigg, and Linda Thorson. So which one of them is the odd one out? Yep, take your time, ladies and gentlemen, because it is about getting it right. And this one, you don't want to lose any points. Okay, so it is Helen Mirren. 13, have you got it right? 5 said Joanna Lumley, 5 said Diana Rigg, and 9 thought Linda Thorson. So sorry, guys, you're going to lose some points on that one. But if you said Helen Mirren, all good. You're going to get extra points. Fastest to the Batcave. Yes, you know the people from Birmingham tonight playing James's family. And well done getting the fastest finger in there. But is that going to make you win this round and the entire game? Well, we'll have to see, won't we? So quiz fact, Helen Mirren was not an Avenger. There we are. So Helen Mirren, yeah. Was not an Avenger. The rest were. That's the Avengers, not the Marvel Avengers. If Tim was on about thinking, well, there's Alan Mirren in Marvel comics. No, Avengers are a different thing. Good quiz. Thank you very much, Dan. I appreciate that. So even though I've messed things up tonight and I've been waffling quite a bit. It must be the fumes, honestly. There's a lot of gloss in this place at the minute. Anyway, right, at the end of the round, fifth place is Grifter, 1,061. So just above the Met factor. Fourth place is Anzar, 1,203 points. Third place is Hobgoblin Queen, Louise, good on you. You're in third there, 1,207 points. Second place, Little Old Wine Drinker Me, 1,320 points. And in first place, though, this round is the Beers, 1,502 points. Absolutely brilliant. But we need to go mix them all up and see who actually won the quiz this week. Is it going to be Little Old Wine Drinker Me? Is it going to be the Beers? Is it going to be the Pecks? Who's going to win this week? Let's have a look. The leaderboard is, right, fifth place, Stick Up Power. Oh, sixth place. I've got this one. The reason I'll do six is because last week's winner is Little Old Wine Drinker Me. The six this week there. Sorry there. 7,752 points. Nicole Paolo, you've scored fifth place tonight. 7,799 points. Fourth place is One Sheets. Two places above Little Old Wine Drinker Me. 8,114 points, so you can laugh at your sister now. No, don't be nasty. It's a weekend. Be nice. Third place is the Pex, 8,451 points. Another one of our winners from the first week, I believe. Team Anzar, second place, 8,689, which is that's where we'll be happy. But again, now our reigning champions, this is three times the Beers, 9,580 points. That's it. So you've won three times now. Your rest have won once. We need to keep these going, ladies and gents. Get winning, because you want to win the tab. Otherwise, Phil and Annie's going to be just digging into their sirloin steaks with peppercorn sauce and 1.5 pints of Foster's. That's what they like, 1.5 pints. Obviously, they'll have more than that, I'm sure, because we've been locked down that much. Somebody placed 8th on the national quiz board, so let's have a look. Always does this. It signs me out. Yeah, so one of you, you're in 8th in the nation. Okay, so that's good. But I'm going to find out who it is so I can let you know, because you always ask me every week who scored what and where you placed. So, leaderboard. 8th place is the Beers. Yeah, the 8th Beers. You scored the 8th place that one. So, next to Wrexham. The top score, however, you scored 9,580 points. Top score was 11,201. And that was PG at the testing poll. Yeah, loads of people playing, stress-free, Redford Arms, Yeah, there's loads of pubs playing tonight. But yeah, no, well done, everyone who's played tonight. Sorry, it was a bit sloppy the way I did it tonight. Just, yes, it wasn't that I didn't want to do it. It's just I was having things going on and doing this and doing that, and I lost track of time. And it's done now, the decorating anyway, so that'll be days. Carpet's getting fitted soon. So yeah, next week it'll be a lot more stress-free, yeah, if you can say that. Obviously, the teams who won last week, you want to come back next week and take the biggest prize off them, feel free to come and join us on Friday at 7:30. Definitely 7:30. Okay. Tim, give us a ring. I'll talk you through, obviously, One Division. Really good. And I'm sure there's lots of other stuff you can watch tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Go do what you want to do. Have a little bit of a drink. It is the weekend. If you're at work or if you're furloughed like myself and others, do what you do every night. Just go get pissed. Yes, that's what it's about, isn't it? So happy days. So thanks for joining in. Appreciate all the time. I'll have, cheers, Chris, again. Drake, good to see you. Can open soon. Yes, well, Drake will probably won't because he's got COVID now, hasn't he? Because he's divvy. He doesn't listen to his own rules. But hopefully, yes, he does make an announcement next week, I think it is, in regards to hospitality opening. I think we'll be the last, though, pubs, sadly. But hey-ho, you can go to the supermarket and you can go get your hair done. At least that will be reopening. Again, he's not on about opening Wrexham, though. That was the one thing he said about Wrexham and Flintshire. He didn't want it to be beauty spots for people to come shopping at a retail environment. Yes, but he might change his mind now he's got COVID. But anyway, no, thanks again, guys. Go enjoy the rest of your evening and have a good sup. And I'll see you same time, well, normal time, 7:30 Friday. All right. Thanks again, all. I'll also see you soon, and I'll reply to some of your messages. All right. Cheers, all. Oh, when I can work out how to do it again. Boom.